Okay, today we're talking about a day in the life of a metal fabricator. So, what does a metal fabricator do? Well, you interpret AutoCAD drawings, referred to as prints. You measure and cut metal per a cut list with a shear, a bandsaw, oxyacetylene torch. In the larger shops that have a higher budget, you may use a CNC machine. You're going to be doing some machining using an end mill, a lathe, a drill press, etc. Be doing some welding, so MIG, TIG, stick. You may even do some brazing, depending on what type of work your particular shop does. And then you may prep work for the welder. So if your shop has an authorized, certified welder or welders, as a fabricator, you may end up cutting, cleaning, grinding, pre-drilling holes. So all the certified welder has to do is grab those prepped parts and weld them together. Again, depends on your specific circumstance. You may manage and order materials. You may even assemble the finished product, as I did. I worked for a very small shop. And you may even paint and palletize the finished product, as I did. Usually, in a small mom and pop shop, you kind of have to be a jack of all trades. Whereas the larger companies, you may have a designated paint shop, a designated shipping department, designated welders, designated metal fabricators, etc. So, welding certifications. Some companies may require that you be a certified welder, some may not. I received my welding certification in 2011, not from the American Welding Society facility, but from an independent third party that my employer at that time used. And you can see on my certification card, it tells you the process, base material, filler metal, thickness, welding positions, what type of joint.
Wow.
So the basic metal fabrication process is as follows. What is the need? So basically, what end product are you trying to create? And then you move on to the design phase. Is there a print already? Or do we need to create an AutoCAD drawing? Is there a hand sketch, something to work off of? From there, from the design concept, we need to come up with a BOM, which stands for bill of materials, and a cut list, and calculate how much time and money is it going to cost to make this product, or multiple pieces if you're making a whole large batch quantity of an object. Then can you get it approved for that price and time frame? If not, you need to stop, modify the design, bill of materials, and resubmit, yes or no. If you do get approval, then you go ahead and complete the fabrication process. So here is an example of a bill of materials. And again, your specific company's bill of materials may look different. This is just an example. On the right, here's an example of a cut list. So this is for all aluminum sheet and bar and block. You can see it lists the dimensions it needs to be cut to and the quantity required. So let's go through some metal fabrication project examples that I've done over my 20-year career. I won't bore you with all of them, waste a bunch of time. We'll just go over a few of them.
Ha
So in this example, I was turning a, I believe it was a tell, excuse me, a 12 or 10 inch diameter, 1 inch thick steel plate on a lathe. We had to put a bevel on this plate to get it prepped for the welding process. This is going to be the closure plate on the bottom of a round pressure vessel. So you can see we're just slowly removing some material bit by bit. Always make sure to use some coolant lubricant when you're performing this kind of process. Clear away the swarf. Always wear PPE like safety glasses. Remember, when you're working on a lathe, don't have long hair, loose clothing, long sleeves. Don't lean over the chuck when it's in operation. Always turn off the power before you have to perform maintenance or change out a tool on it. Here we're looking at an end mill, and it's, you can see we're just machining out some aluminum on this U-channel. Specifically, it's architectural 6063 aluminum U-channel. And the three slots are being machined out, and I had to make a series of these storage brackets that will get cleaned up and mounted to the wall to store hoses for my previous employer. So again, I made this AutoCAD drawing on an Autodesk product called Fusion 360. I made the 3D model. Once my boss approved the 3D model, I then generated the multi-view drawing with dimensions. Woo! A few years back, I want to say in 2010, I designed and created this battery jumper cart for a previous employer. Basically, the concept here was two 12-volt batteries would sit on this cart. There's positive and negative jumper cables. And depending on which way you threw that knife switch, you would get 12 volts or 24 volts, depending on the system that you're trying to jumpstart. And we used a trickle charger to keep these two batteries charged up at all times, sometimes called a battery maintainer. You see in this drawing, I listed part numbers, pricing, dimensions. And then here is the finished product. So here's yet again another metal fabrication product that I designed and built. Here's it getting installed. So basically there's a worm and wheel drive that you turn, and it rotates that platform 360 degrees. My current employer, the pump technicians would bolt their pumps to this platform, and they would be able to rotate the pumps upside down, sideways, right side up, etc. And that greatly reduced the amount of labor and time because they didn't have to unbolt the pump, reposition it. It also saved a lot of strain on the employees, helped them work more efficiently, productively, and safely. And this got bolted directly to a concrete wall with reinforcement plates on the outside of the concrete wall.
Wow.
And you can see there's also a support stanchion that we added. Around 2014, I designed and built this hydroelectric oil filter crusher for my previous employer. So this was a concept drawing I gave to my employer, my boss. Once he approved it, I ordered my materials, my parts, did all the metal fabrication, put it together, painted it, tested it, and there's the finished product in use in the heavy equipment shop. Later in 2022, I refined the design, made some improvements, as you see here in this drawing, and I used the AutoCAD program for that. Here is a 50-gallon capacity portable oil drain pan. You can see we use an expanded metal for the top grate. Has a drain plug, has a swivel caster in the front, a T-handle to pull it around. So here again, I'd order the materials, do all the welding and cleanup work, do a water test or leak test, make sure all the welds are good, nothing leaks, then paint it and put it in service. Woo! And they would use these to drain used oil out of heavy equipment, to do oil changes and whatnot. Anyways, I hope this information helps and gives you an idea of what it's like to be a metal fabricator. Please like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment. Thanks for watching.